We're doomed!
See if this intake server works better. I think it may have. Yeah, okay. So I think that was, fortunately not us, but I think that was two of the Twitch servers that just crashed. So that's unfortunate. Hopefully that's going to stop right there because we don't want any more... Yeah, this intake server seems to be better. So sorry about that, guys. Hopefully it's not going to cause any lag issues for you out there. But we've switched to the London server instead of the Frankfurt or the Amsterdam one. We did just miss the knife round here, unfortunately. But I think maybe we caught the tail end of it as Titan are going to be choosing to start on the counter-terrorist side of Mirage. So welcome to the show once again. And I think we're going to be all right now. It seems to be working. But yeah, Twitch intake servers, they usually are pretty stable, but sometimes not.
Crashed, Anders, or taken down by Google?
Illuminati.
I mean...
Illuminati. Hashtag.
I'm willing to believe almost anything at this point. Now, here we go. Ready and waiting, SLTV Star Series Season 10. Let's get it on. Scream and Kenny defending the bombsite here against the incoming Mouse Sports team. The German-Serbian-Finnish mix that's going into the bombsite already, and it's looking pretty good. Some nice shots from existence. Does take a Nuki, or actually Tabson very low here, as Chris is going to get the opening kill on Scream and chases Kenny all the way back to the CT spawn.
Yeah, Kenny's stuck, really not going to be able to get out of there. Alu finds the headshot on him. Alu continues to hunt down existence as well. Unrelenting pressure coming out here from Mouseborn. They're not willing to let Titan get into any kind of position to set up a retake from CT at least. But two members here are going to chase Alu back, and we did get a pretty solid kill towards mid as well. So now it's going to come down to KZ and his teammate Legia.
Yeah, Leggy and out lone. Bomb is already being defused. He's going to have to walk out and get a straight kill on the defuser, and they let him do it. What on earth, Titan? There's no time for stuff like that. A second one, and that wins the round. Vendetta, the buddy system has never been weaker.
Yeah, that's like soap opera buddy program type of thing.
Just pretending to be friends and then stabbing your friends in the back.
Exactly.
That is almost certainly what we just saw.
That's a shame for Titan to lose that one. Existence did a great job at the beginning of the round, picking up two kills and also doing quite a bit of damage, actually, to several Mouseports members. So that's unfortunate, and that should normally not happen at all.
They knew where he was, they had three people, they could have almost just body-blocked him, and it would have been enough to save that round. It looked like they just made a straight entrance, and he just plowed his way through with the Glock and got those kills, so... Pretty much not ideal, and now Alu opening up with a really good headshot onto Smiths. They're going for the A-bomb site again, and why not? It worked last time, but they're being careful about it, Mouseports.
Well, they realize that there's scouts in play here. Existence taking a shot and missing on Alu isn't going to help things here, but Alu manages to dash back into safety. And now Mouseport's are going to set up for a second round here, but at least now they kind of have an idea of the firepower they're dealing with on Titan's side.
There's definitely good information coming out right here. One of the scouts is actually... None of the scouts are here right now. One is making its way in on Existence with the CT spawn, but... Tabson goes down. It's a nice shot from Kenny. See if he can pick up a second one as well. NBK and Existence after two scouts. Misses a shot. There's a body shot coming out, but Existence is going to go down. So this time the investment, which is one we've been seeing a lot more recently, it doesn't actually work out all that well for Titan.
It doesn't, but then again, they were in the situation where they could allow themselves to fully buy up. So it's not going to impact them at all. It just means that they won't have that many CZ-75s and whatnot in the upcoming round, but for the buy round, it's not going to be an issue at all.
Just to point out real quick, while we're in another round of eco here for Titan, this is a big match for Mouseports, and this strong start is very good for them, because they are within striking distance of actually closing the gap with the top teams, with the top four teams, basically, who will be going on to the LAN event of this group stage. Of this tournament, but only LDLC and Na'Vi are ahead of Mouseports right now. Mouseports currently sitting at 7-0-2. So if they were to pick up a win here, get to that eighth win, that would put them on par with ESG and Na'Vi. So that's a bit scary there. That really gives them a shot at fourth position.
Wow, and it would be extremely big to beat Titan, especially with the stand-in, because KZ is playing and not Nuki, which would normally be in the lineup.
Yep. Maybe that's going to work their way, though. I mean, if they go for not, you know, it's just not like random play, but if they go for more aggressive play because of that, maybe that's going to be enough to catch Titan off guard.
Well, Mouseports are usually a very aggressive team on the CT side, which is why I like to watch them so much on this map.
Chris goes down early on, though, and it's going to be Tabs and then KZY coming through with some kills, and they just clean up the bomb side in spite of that early stack coming up from Titan, which seemed like a good idea, but then it wasn't enough anyway. So that's a bit of a shame. I mean, they only picked up the two kills. That's a round that they maybe could have won if they had landed some shots there.
If they could have just picked up a little bit more. Existence, for example, looking towards B apartments, wasn't able to pick up a frag. And the rest of the defense kind of folded as soon as that kind of... I mean, as soon as Mouseports were able to get control of short and move up towards that B site, the rest of Titan were kind of caught out in the open, weren't they? Yeah. And right now, this is kind of shaping up to be another round here for Mouseports. Although, if NBK with that CZ could pick up another frag, that would be huge, and he does! So that's a really solid eco round there from Titan. Three kills is good work from them.
Not at all bad. Keeping Mouseports economy maybe a little bit lower than it otherwise would have been, but it is still looking pretty strong right now. It's 7,000 on Leggy. He only died once and has 6 kills. That is a bit of a bank suddenly going into the 4th round right here. And now it is time for Titan to step it up. They have the AWP on Kenny, although he has no body armor, which is actually a bit of a worry. You can get grenaded down on this map, but they're going to go super aggressive in the middle and try and see if they can pick somebody off here. Scream and Kenny backing him up. I like this position from Titan.
We need to see Kenny land some shots, and he's going to get it. Second try. He drops dangerously low, though, and Smiths is going to have to come up big here. He has to pick off Legia when he peeks around the corner, but he's not going to get the job done. Legia gets that kill, and Kenny S is still pretty low. He has to back off, and they are going to give some ground here, Titan.
Chris missing a shot, a very important shot now. He's actually trapped in a weird corner, and Scream takes him down with ease. So a bit of a shame there. That could have been a big opening, unfortunately, for Mouseports. It doesn't work out that way, and they're going to rotate back towards the B bomb site. What do you think about this, man?
I think it's okay. They have no presence towards the A bomb site anyway, so rotating all the way over would probably take too long and would have been easy to sniff out for Titan.
Flashbangs raining in through Legia, leading the charge and takes down Kenny in the back there. Now NBK can't see a thing. He's going to drop Mouseports, doing very fine work here with this. The grenade, Scream's going to come in, deny the plant, but is it going to be enough? It's still a 2-on-2. 30-second Scream falls, and Existence is going to try and come in and see if he can clutch this 1-on-2.
Yeah, Legia with a sick play there, catching Scream off guard. That's three frags now for Legia, and that is just fantastic work. It's Existence who has to work his way up short. He already headshots Legia, or at least drops him down to 15. Drops him down to 6. He's putting shots through that bench, but Aldo has given away his position now in B apartments. And this gets so much more difficult for Existence. He's going to eat nade damage as well moving on to this site. But this is Aldo. This bomb is planted for Aldo. There's no way he's going to let Existence get away with this.
No, shouldn't be possible. Existence tries to fake it once, but now too much time has already passed. And Alu going to walk in here and take the kill. That's a double for the Finnish star. And we are going to be looking at a 4-0 scoreline. Titan not really picking up in that round, in spite of some early kills coming in there in the middle.
Morales got overwhelmed as Mouseports took that B-bomb site. I guess it's just unfortunate. That's something that can happen, regardless of what kind of defense that you had, because Titan had yet to make any rotations, so that was not the issue or anything. They just got gunned down.
Now they're trying for a bit of an aggressive push up in the apartments, where they're going to run right into Kenny, and he goes down with ease, in fact. Does do some damage to Tabson, but not enough. So Mouseports, I'm impressed here, and they had a really, really good land at Gfinity. Impressed everyone, I think, with how well they performed. MBK is going to be walking right into Legia, and he still turns around. The flashbang helped him, takes the kill. And should be going down, though, but somehow he's still alive, and I have no idea how. Smiths is fighting it out with him, and Legia is still going to be alive. That's a double kill that he should not have had. Wow.
Best flash of the night. Just catching NBK point blank right there. NBK, he's got to be furious. The luck. Incredible that you didn't die. Yeah, NBK is not pleased right now with that.
No, definitely not. I can't really blame him for it either. That must have been a disappointing turn of events for MBK.
But now, I mean, I do like how Mouseports are deciding to play this. Now we go into the second big buy round here for Titan, 6th round, and they've still yet to get anything really rolling for them. Scream with a good push down A pit, and this has become one of Titan's go-to plays, but Aldo is going to be able to catch Scream off guard and trade that to a 1v1.
Yeah, and this is not working out well. Kenny goes down as well. Two people defending here. And now it's just the one. Smiths, I mean, Titan, they're not working at all right now as a team. They seem to be completely malfunctioning. They got the first kill, which is great, but then they turned their backs on the ramp and just decided, well, nothing more is going to happen here.
And this gets really difficult now. NBK's got the AWP for Titan, but he's coming up from Connector. Not necessarily the best spots. Not sure if he spotted Tapson out there, but Smith's, he's getting eyes on the site. He's trying to put shots through the box, but Mouseports, they just play the bomb at this point. They really don't need to give opportunities to Titan to get frags as they take out Tapson. There's still KZ and Alu alive, though. And as I say that, it's going to come down to Alu. Smith gets on the bomb, and Alu, he's going to get one frag. He goes for the spray, and he doesn't manage to drop Smith's.
Well, if you have to win a round, at least let it be a round like that where you just managed to ninja defuse it in the smoke like that. So definitely very, very fortunate for Titan, and hopefully that could give them some confidence back. Although I wouldn't say that it's going to be too much. Right now, they are being dropped by Legia and Alu, who are dropping 11 and 9 kills at the moment. So that's looking really good. And Titan, I mean, that wasn't a round that they won because of any kind of great execution. Just more, I mean, one more bullet would have landed in, that would have been it.
Well, Titan again going for the aggression towards a pit, pushing two guys out there, in fact, this time around. NBK up in B apartments taking some fire. But I do like the fact that Titan are trying to throw their weight around. They really do need to be doing this at this point because they are behind right now in the half. And they need to be just kind of crushing Mouseports and getting that momentum going their way. So the pushes, we'll see if they work, but Existence gets flashed. And Mouseports are wise to what Titan are up to. They know that somebody pushed down there and they're able to get the kill pretty simply there.
And that boost up there is really cool. That's something we've seen Titan do, but obviously Mouseports have too, because the peeking that angle is not a common thing. So I love the fact that they did that. It's clearly showing that Mouseports have done their homework here, and that they're taking this best of one match quite seriously. And if they win it now, they could boost themselves all the way up to almost, what, an 8-1 scoreline, basically, before Titan can think about buying again. This is really scary. This is going to be a double eco for Titan. If they lose it, look at the money. They have $150 combined. They can't lose this round. Oh, but a great Molotov.
Yeah, this is going to force him out in the open. Smith's is roasting alive, and Smith's burns to death. Taps in KZ, and then Kenny S tries to get something going for him, but it's not going to happen. NBK gets caught by Legia at the top of mid. He's finally going to get the kill, but it's just too little too late here. Mouseports with four guys left alive. Three guys left alive. NBK not willing to give up, so that's good, but he's not going to be able to make it out of there alive. And Mouseports, six rounds now on the board for them. This is a fantastic first half for them, and that completely slaughters Titan's money. We're looking at, like, potentially 7 to 8 rounds here for Mouseports at the very beginning of this half.
Yeah, this is just a devastating result. Vendetta, I mean, are you as stunned as the rest of us?
Not really, actually. I think Mouseports play a really solid Mirage. And, well, they've only gotten better with time, so I'm actually not too surprised, especially with how wobbly Titan has seemed so far tonight.
C-set picked up, and Kenny making short work of Legia, so that's a good re-peek. But you're right, they have been playing really well, and yeah, maybe Mouseports improving, maybe Titan deteriorating a little bit, at least in these online matches, they've been looking a little bit inconsistent. And that's not good. I think Mirage is supposed to be a map that Titan plays pretty well, right?
It's supposed to be, I mean, it used to be one of their stronger maps because they were one of the first teams to take Mirage, the new version of Mirage, that is, after Valve, you know, switched it up from CE. But like, they were one of the first teams along with Fnatic to really put a lot of attention on this map and try and figure out all the bugs, try and figure out everything that was wrong with the map, essentially, so that they could abuse it. But since then, it's just been so long now, like 7-8 months, and a lot of teams have caught up to Titan, and I don't really feel like Titan are as dominant as they used to be. They're not up to like the Dignitas, Na'Vi level, essentially, on this map.
Now this time it's going to be a really fast push, and NBK's here with a scout. They did force it up this round. NBK is going to go down as he burns alive once again. It's the flames that eat them, and it's going to be a 3-on-4 here. Existence coming up from lower is not going to be working it. Happen, it's Chris Jay to take him down, and Scream and Kenny are left, and Kenny will get flashed and taken down by Legia, and it's Alu to fall, but then Legia with a quick double kill, and the round is won. It's 8-1 as predicted here. Titan just not connecting the dots at the moment.
Ben, what do you make of this progression so far? I mean, it's like a combination of basically Mouseports just playing really well and Titan not landing the shots that they need to be landing right now. Do you see anything different here?
No, that's the easy way to go about it. Mouseports are executing pretty well. The setups that Titan are doing, there's nothing wrong with the setups they've had so far. I think they've had some good ideas with doing the Titan push, I guess you could call it, down to pit with Existence to Scream and whatnot. I think they've been doing things pretty alright. It's just that
they're getting outgunned when it comes down to it. They're losing aim duels, and they're not able to trade properly.
Scream down here towards the A slope. Has to stay alive. The bomb has dropped all the way, and they actually do have a man advantage for once, Titan. Something is actually working out for them. Now they need to hold on to this, and Chris is going to go down. Kenny not missing the opportunity, and that's obviously important. It's Alu and Tamsin left, and let's see if we can catch some action from Alu as he's moving up towards the ramp here. Picks up an AWP, which he is really frightening with as well.
He is very good with it. But I do like that Mouseworts, they're not going to go for anything crazy because they still have 40 seconds left. So it's not the end of the world. They are starting to get a bit tight on time, but doesn't necessarily mean that Alu has to throw it away. 30 seconds, and they are moving to this B site. And I do like the play that they're going for the B site as well, seeing as how this, you know, commonly will be the there will be less defenders here to stop them. But we need to see just a sick shot from Alu basically to open anything up.
And they are in position Titan as well with NBK and Smiths here. They should be able to hold it down. Alu peeking right here, misses the one, and good spray from NBK. That should be the round sealed as there is just 8 seconds left. And Tabson is going to decide, well, we do have a lot of money, but we can use a little bit more in saving an AWP. And that's a smart choice.
Counter-terrorists win. I hope that he lives. Yeah, he will. Okay. Yes, well played by Tabson. I thought that he was going to get flanked there from B apartments for a second. So that was a little bit scary.
It does make it out. And it's not like the money situation for Mouse Sports. This is anything to be afraid of at this point. Oh, Mouse doesn't have to be afraid at this point. Because they have won so many rounds in a row. So I think they'll be alright for a couple of rounds more.
Chris out ops Kenny in the middle. And it's not a best start for Titan. Down and underpass, Smith ate a grenade, but he's going to be pushing up. I'm not sure they realize he's here. That was just a cautionary grenade, and he's going to have some good timing here as Chris goes down next in line. Legia won't be falling, so thought that could have been a really great double kill from Smith. But in fact, they're just back into a 3-on-3, and Mousesports still have plenty of time to decide where they want to go with this.
That was actually a really smart move from Smith. After he got the first kill, he kind of backed off and more or less faked the death cam before he went aggressively up again to take out one more member from Mousesports. So I think that's, he definitely did his part that round. And right now, there's not really a lot that Mousesports can do in terms of taking his site conservatively, but I guess that's the kind of thing they have to hope for, one of the players actually coming up big more than anything else.
Turns it into a 2-on-2, Existence and MBK scrambling to get this bomb site. Well, Existence is already here, MBK has to move quickly. 30 seconds left, no bomb plan yet, of course. And Titan, they gotta win this round, but Legia seems to be an unstoppable force at this point. Finally goes down, maybe I cursed him. Now it's the stand-in KZY versus NBK, and NBK will come out on top. Jumps around, a little bit of a celebration there as Titan do win another round, finally.
Finally is right. Now they need to get the remaining 4 rounds, essentially. So we shall see if they can get them, but this needs to end 8-7 for Titan to have a strong shot in the second half. They cannot afford to give away anything else to Mousesports. And Mousesports are currently sitting at that that 8 rounds, obviously, but they've also got quite a good buy going in. They decide to just go straight up rushing onto the A site. Scream is here, but Chris J lands a good shot on the man holding CT, and this is looking like Mousesports are kind of getting caught in a box here. Titan are just closing in on them, but Chris J is making it happen.
Yeah, great shots coming out, but it's not enough. It's going to be Alu alone, picks up the one kill here, and now it's a 1-on-2, and Smiths finds the kill. I think if Christian had got that shot on Scream, who was in the towards Shadows, that would have been a very different round. But that was a bit of a crazy no-scope flick, so couldn't really count on that. Now it's 8-4. And even if Titan make it back to 8-7, I still don't think this is going to be quite a good enough half for them. But obviously, at that point, they can make a comeback into the game. And they've gone for a double-up setup here on the CT side. So they're finally starting to connect the dots.
They are, and even better. Mousesports has the eco now. Even though they don't have that little of money, they could have probably made a force buy happen. They want to save it in. But this also gives Titan more time to build an economy.
Existence playing with fire there in apartments as well. We can see he got dropped down to 22, and that's way too close for comfort. Alu almost taking him out with the CZ. So, I mean, good play from Titan, but Existence going alone is not the best sort of situation, even though you can kind of expect there to just be one guy up in apartments like that. Smiths is having a field day right now as Mousesports try and push up from A spawn, or rather A pit, and Chris J is going to be the last man alive here. Does rush down Kenny S, so that's nice. If he can get another kill, that'd be good, but it's not going to happen. Scream shuts him down, and, well, Titan have got 5 on the board. they get the last two, I mean, it's conceivable. They could take these the last two rounds and actually make this a very close game.
Certainly be a pretty cool comeback if it turns out like that. Malosports have seen just really, really good in the last couple of rounds here, so be impressed if the French-Belgian team can come back into it like that. And it's MBK leading the charge, which seems to often be the case whenever Titan are really far behind. They turn to NBK to make it happen. Smith with a sick flick down towards the underpass, takes down Tabs and just walks out and makes it happen. Even though they were jumping down those stairwell there, that still works out great. Now, what is going to be the plan here for Mousesports? They're a man down, and they seem to have had pretty good success at the A bomb side. I'd sort of like to see them go back and try and play just a standard A take, actually.
Well, with a minute, they can still play for picks. That's the thing. They can still hope to catch somebody off guard from Titan. And Chris J up in A apartments like this, if Scream decides to peek again, that could be a nice kill for him. They still have a man looking towards mid as well, Alu, with that his AWP. So they could try and shape things up, but they've passed the minute mark. They're in the 40 seconds now, and this is starting to kind of fall apart now. There we go. Chris J picks it up.
Yeah, but that was after missing a shot on Kenny. He just walks out. He should have been dead there. Now he re-peeks, and Kenny will take him down. That could have been an incredible situation for Chris, but Legia will open it up. Now NBK is the only one defending. He's been so big in this game so far, but he has to be even bigger right now. Misses the spray almost entirely. He's down to 8 HP. Does get the kill. Grenade will finish him off, and it's a 2-on-2. Kenny missing a shot, and the bomb is not planted yet. 20 seconds. Existence walking up from the side. They don't know he's there. Oh, no. He misses the shot, and still no bomb plant happening. Mousesports delaying this into a 1-on-2. Kenny misses one more shot, and that might be the last one he's going to get here. 8 seconds. He picks up the one. The bomb is dropped, and Alu creeping in on him. 4 seconds. They're walking around. This is ringing around the Rosie, and there's the no-scope. Oh, my God. Alu, are you joking? That's a triple kill in the last second. He steals it away from Titan.
I don't even know. Why didn't Case, he just put down the bomb? He had 3 or 4 different situations where he could have put down the bomb with fairly, you know, fairly ease. Still, that made it so much more closer from us worse than what it had to be.
And now look at Alu. Now he's reached the god tier level, just running out of smoke and picking off people towards the A ramp. That's so ridiculous, because that's just a massive risk, but he made it look incredibly easy. Now up in the apartments, he's going to be walking through even more smoke. He's just not even afraid any longer. And I'm wondering if Titan are going to be able to deal with this kind of insanity.
Well, look at Smith's position right here. That, I think that's definitely going to catch Casey and Tabs in off guard. And she should be able to pick up at least one frag here.
He should be. I absolutely agree. If only someone could flash him in, that would be even better, but
they've actually left him all alone on A.
And MBK goes down. Now they're going to be checking, but Casey, why? Not checking thoroughly enough, and Smith is going to again be turning his back, just like last time. Almost goes down to it when he re-peaks. Does do some damage onto Tabson. Jumping down is Alu with the pistol in hand. Is going to take down Smith, leaving Kenny in a 1-on-3 for the 15th round.
I think Smith has some of the most unfortunate timings in CS at the moment.
Kenny?
It was just... Ooh.
Picks up the bomb as well. Now it's on Legia, who's been doing so well. Top fragging almost, and there it is. Double kill for him. He's tied with Alu, both 19 kills, and it's going to be 10-5, and you're right. Definitely not the best timing coming out from Smiths here. That's an incredible first half for Mousesports. A big upset, I would say. Titan, not really connecting the dots just here.
Then I'm curious to see if Mousesports are going to continue to play as aggressively on their CT side as they normally do. Because it's one that's really fun to watch, and it might throw off Titan completely.
Well, it could be. Well, if you're just joining us, then welcome to Room on Fire. This is the SLTV Star Series game between Titan and Mousesports. We do have one more coming up for you, which is going to be Navi and LDLC.com. It's going to be a really, really fun game, so don't want to miss that either. Big thanks to everyone who's tuning in here, joining us and enjoying the game, and I hope you guys are going to invite your friends, follow and subscribe to the channel as well. Remember to click the Facebook link at the bottom of the page. There's a bit of a picture down there where you can participate in a raffle, and it's easy, and you can win all sorts of cool stuff. This week, it's a solid state drive from Team Group, so definitely go and do that. Now, we're just about ready here with the second half. Semler, what do you think? Do you believe in this comeback from Titan?
Maybe? No? I mean, Mousesports, if they play this well, they only need to get 6 rounds on the CT side of Mirage. I mean, Titan, if anybody can do it, it's them, but this is a tall task. And look at Mousesports. They've already pushed up the top mid. They're going to get information. This is going to play out perfectly for Titan. They should be able to get onto this site now and get this plant without too much trouble.
Kenny charging in here. Adu was waiting for him, but can't find the kill. And now Kenny going hyper-aggressive and maybe even too much here. He should be going down. That was a bit of a misplay from Mousesports. Kenny should have been killed almost instantly then. And KCY trying to see if he can bring it back with a really good headshot on Smiths. Chris J staying alive, and he's right next to Scream Existence, picking off Legia. And this is looking like a great round from Titan, as KCY is going to be left alone. Goes down. So all in all, it works out pretty well. But Vendetta, did you see that that action with Kenny staying alive?
Yeah, I saw Kenny. Kenny's shenanigans. And yeah, you're right. I think it was a bit too crazy. But in the end, it works out, so guess you can't really fault him for it. And he did pick up a kill, so it's not all bad.
It is not all bad. Oh. There we go. Bit of a weird thing with my browser, sorry. It's going to be Smiths in the middle pushing up, and already they've taken down Legia. So we're in the 17th round, and it'd be a pretty incredible comeback if they can make it happen here on the Titan side. But obviously, they are going to be able to maybe equalize the score and make it something like 8-10. But at that point, Mousesports are going to be having rifles, and the game will be just a little bit different, right?
Yeah, and yeah. Losing Smiths like that, not a great start. Luckily for them, though, they have already gotten two frags. And I guess we can keep in mind that Titan did almost bring it back versus VODS Pro after a pretty lackluster first half. So if they find their pace, if maybe MBK is the one to get hot this game, or Kenny has a similar game, then who knows what happens.
I think two members on Titan need to warm up, basically. Like in the first match of the night, it looked a little shifty, but still, it was like Scream and Kenny who were doing a lot of the work. Like, we need to have two members from Titan wake up here. Like, Kenny and X, Scream or MBK. Because otherwise, I think they're gonna have trouble dealing with Mousesports.
Right now, they're opting for the right bomb site, though. Going towards A, there's absolutely no Mousesports members near, so easy bomb plant and should be enough time for them to actually get into a proper bomb plant position or after plant position. And the best Mousesports can hope for at this point is exit kills.
Yeah, which I guess is not quite good enough here, but they are going to try anyway. KCY looking for a deagle shot on somebody. The Titan have at least played these last couple of rounds reasonably, and that's what they need to do. If they want to get back into it, they need some sort of mental advantage as well. KCY does take down Kenny, so overall, Mousesports, they do a little bit of damage, and now they're going to be able to actually... No, they're going to have to eco once more, sorry. So, not quite there yet, but this is sort of... I mean, I don't know. I'm still a little bit confused about what's happening overall to Mousesports. They just don't seem to be showing up that much today. Oh, sorry, not Mousesports, Titan.
Yeah, that's... And, you know, it's the reason why we continuously try and... Or not continuously, but, you know, still, we knock Titan is that we expect a whole different level from them, right? Especially after their performance at G3. Like, they should not be struggling in best-of-one online matches. I mean, granted, okay, the way that they look at it is a bit jaded. I mean, Existence himself has said, you know, that basically best-of-ones online, they're settled within the first 7 rounds. And then it's just, you know, that's it. Like, the game is done within the first 7 rounds. Like, that's the way that Titan look at these games. So I think they need to get over that, basically, and figure out how to work their way back into a match, even if they don't have a stellar start.
Yeah, but sometimes I guess it is easier said than done. And as we said earlier, maybe, just maybe, they are also focused a little bit on other things. But they don't want to get, you know, knocked out of Starseries here. I mean, that's not what we're at right now. But they really don't want to end up in a situation where they're not going to make the finals. Because Starseries is a pretty prestigious event. And it's going to be a lot of hype around once it rolls around. And of course, we'll be covering on the channel here as well. Chris goes down. And the defense crumbling at the A bomb site right now for Mousesports. Which is not surprising, considering they really didn't have a lot of anything here.
Agreed. Oh, let's see. MBK with a good peek towards CT spawn. Gets good spray onto Alu. He has the chance to pick off KZY as well, who's waiting just down the other edge. MBK not going to get him, though. Has to fall back, and that's smart play from MBK. Leave the kill to Scream. Get a perfect anti-eco. Just clean play there from Titan, and that's another step closer to them actually tying up this match. But here's the first hurdle for them. You know, they got through the pistol round, but now there's the buy round for Mousesports. And they do have an AWP not on Chris J, which is interesting. They're putting it on Alu.
I don't really blame them. Chris has been missing a couple of shots here, and Alu has been looking just outright monstrous, so why not give it to the Finnish madman and make that work for them? And Titan really don't have one. They have, in fact, 3 Galils and 2 AKs, though a bunch of smokes, and interestingly, a lot of Molotovs as well. I think if Titan get into the site and put the bomb down here, they can hold it down for such a long time with all these grenades. And in the shadow, KZY running out, in fact, and that's a really good choice. Now he's hiding in a much better corner, and the backup is being called for. Mouseports, can they hold it down here? They don't want to allow Titan to get back in. There's Alu picking up the shot. Bomb will go down, and Alu with a second shot with the AWP. Tabson is going to take down Smithson. KZY falls. It's a 2-on-3, now a 1-on-3. Existence not happy about the situation. NBK trying to see if he can hold it off here, but he's being smoked out. He's running through, and Tabson will take him down. And that's going to be it. What a round for Mouseports.
And we see why they let Alu go to town with that off. Those two first entry frags were so big for Mouseports, and I think they kept Casey alive for way longer than what he should have been.
Just maybe so, right? It's definitely turning out a little bit unfortunate, but the position he took up early on, I mean, that's pretty smart. He realized if he's going to be waiting in the smoke, he couldn't really help out a lot, and he would ultimately probably just gone down. So moving out of that is, I think that was a wise choice at the end.
Oh yeah, absolutely. He didn't get to do all that much that round, but just having Titan players knowing that he's there is probably enough to create a distraction.
Smokes again. KZY in a slightly different position this time. A flash goes in, and Molotov to the position where he's no longer at. That would have been great one round ago. This round, not so much. Tamsin goes down, and KZY will fall as well. Bomb will be planted here. Alu cannot stop it. They're trying to boost on through here or shoot through the smoke, but it's not really connecting. Legia picks up a kill, but I'm not sure if this is not too late. Titan have done a great job this round getting into the bomb site.
This time around, it works, and they should be able to hold. Again, NBK finds Chris J going through the murder hole, and that's not going to help things here as Legia and Alu are getting outflanked. Quick two kills coming from Kenny S to clean up everything. But that time around, it worked for Titan. You would think that it would have worked the round before that, because I really did like the smokes that they put down, but Alu, of course, with that AWP, ruined their day. This time around, Titan, good smokes and good kills. They get the kills that matter.
That's very, very interesting. Actually, you can see that that they were trying for a bit of a ninja defuse. I think at the end they had to smoke off on the bomb, but Titan managed to deny it. So now we're at 11-9, and I think at this point it feels like the comeback is actually not that unreal any longer.
Well, yeah. Mouseports half to eco. It's most likely going to be 10-11, and it feels pretty open from that point on. But I still hold Mouseports as favorites going further into this game, simply because they are on the more favored side. But Titan have definitely been picking things up.
They have been doing so. Bit of a... I don't know, actually, I was going to say they have two people in the bomb site, which is good, but now one of them runs away. That's Legia, and Chris is going to go down, so this is going to be 10-11 now. Smoke off from Legia is fun, but it's not quite good enough. And now is he going to try and hide in here? He has a kit. This would be the most incredible ninja defuse, but and even just the idea, I'm a big fan of it, but it doesn't work out that way, unfortunately, for him. Well, you saw what was happening there. He was going to try for the Sparkles play, essentially.
Yeah, I was following Scream, and they knew he was there because Scream got around the pillar on A site, the left side pillar towards short right. He got around that corner just in time to see Legia like run into the smoke. So maybe if that smoke went down, they could have thought it was the man throwing it from kitchen or something like that, but Scream kind of ruined Legia's play there this time.
Sadly, right? It would have been a really great moment if that could have worked out.
He gets a golden star. He gets a gold star for creativity, right?
But yeah, A for effort and all of that.
A for effort, but not this time. Titan aren't going to... It doesn't seem like Titan are going to let up. I mean, they've taken how many rounds? Oh, we can't actually see. So they've taken quite a few rounds in a row now, I think. So they're starting to get a little bit of momentum going their way, and that's the most important thing here for Titan, because they are, like Vendetta said, you know, they're on the least favorite side. So they have the harder job here. So they need to have the confidence going into this, landing the shots and getting the right reads and basically just overpowering Mouseports.
They've been doing a fine job here in the second half as they do spot Alu in the window, and it's not smoked off, which was intentional. They just had the smoke so they can get behind the boxes there. So Alu's now going to be smoked off and moving away from that. And Mouse Sports have three people committed pretty heavily to the Zay bomb site. In fact, pretty far up as well. It's going to be Tamsin thinking about going down. There's a flash over. He spots MBK, but it's Alu in the middle who opens up at the kill there. MBK taking the challenge, and Tamsin comes up big with the kill on him. Now Smith and Screamer left boosting into the room here, but Alu sees it coming and takes down Smith. Seems like, I don't know, Alu is just playing at such an insane level. It's really just a pleasure to watch him.
I think he's got all the Titan members tracked with GPS or something.
He knows.
He's definitely playing well, and in a lot of ways he's keeping Mousesports in this game, which seems weird seeing how they're ahead, but Titan have definitely been the team on fire the last couple of rounds. So I think they definitely needed that, so good ground coming up from Alu, and the best thing Scream can hope to do is really save, but there's so much time left, so I'm not really sure if he's going to be able to.
We shall find out. Scream running into Tabson, and he will go down. Unfortunate. Try to pick the best place that he could. That's now 12-10, so just when it seems like it's working out so well for Titan, and they're making this cool comeback, they end up losing a round, and that has to be pretty disheartening.
That's not the best feel for Titan, but at least for them, they still have the money to buy, so they're not out of this game yet. As soon as they're forced to eco Titan, this is pretty much game, because Mousesports are going to be way too close. I mean, if they eco, Titan should be able to force up in the next round, but Mousesports are going to be way too close to netting that 16th round if Titan are forced on the pistols, so all the pressure on Titan continues to be on Titan, essentially, because they can no longer make a single mistake, and Kenny is going to find Alu to start, so at least, you know, the peek on the short actually pays off.
And killing Alu right now has to count basically double. That's a big pickoff coming in from Kenny. And now are they wrapping around? They're in the middle, but looks like they want to rotate back towards the A-bomb site and actually taking the bomb all the way back to Terra Spawn. So I'm not sure if Mousesports are going to be ready for this. They do have two people inside, but the backup I think is going to be a little bit far away. I do like this position from Chris. It means he can go a little bit faster, but I still think K-Set Y and Tabson have to come up with some big kills, and there's the first one on NBK. That's so important. Now, all of a sudden, if they push in, they have to worry about the flank from apartments, but he's actually going to go back out and Molotov up here. There's not a lot of time left. Mousesports might have come up with a really good plan right now.
Well, they might have, but Existence, he gets a great flank up from Connector, and that opens up a kill on Tabson. He even picks off the man KZY, who's trying to rotate back to that site. Now Titan have taken quite a bit of damage, but Mousesports still have to land some pretty important shots here to keep them from getting onto this site and getting the plant. Scream is going to be able to put the bomb down here for Titan, and he's not exactly in the best spot, but at least Kenny has kind of got Overwatch, and he's going to pick off Chris J through the smoke.
Well, Legia should have definitely got that kill on Smith, so that's unfortunate. Doesn't have a grenade to finish it off, and he's going to go down. Scream with the headshot, and Titan surviving on very little HP, but survive they do, and they'll be living just a little bit longer here. 12-11.
I'm actually a bit disappointed in Mousesports basically not having any sort of rotation at all after Casey picks up that frag and apps. I would have liked to see them leave Legia pretty much alone on the catwalk area, and if they go B, then sure, that's fine. Let's go for a retake after that and kind of just stack up on A, because that's where you've got your information.
Wow. I mean, right now it comes down to some of those calls, and when they're not working out, that could be fatal. MBK does go down, but at this point it doesn't matter that much because it's the B push coming in here with the bomb and everything, and obviously Mousesports are ecoing and they're not making the most of it. Good kill from Tabson will also end him at he runs out of bullets with the CC at 75, and it's Chris now in a 1-on-3 right here.
Chris is going to save this rifle, which is the right move to make. I mean, you're going to eco. If you can pick up an AK, hold on to it. It's the right call. Save some money in the next round. Maybe drop for a teammate who's fairly low. So it's a really a smart play here from Chris J. Titan, I mean, they very nearly lost Scream as well there. So it was very close there that they could have actually only lived with two members, and that would have been a fantastic eco for Mousesports. But Titan, at least they managed to bounce back and bring it to 12-12. So, I mean, we still have a match on our hands, guys. This is still, I mean, it feels like anybody's game. Even if Mousesports are on the favorite side, it doesn't really seem like they're able to put a stop to Titan's pushes.
I wouldn't be surprised if we saw a buy coming out of Mousesports' stuff coming around. As long as Chris survives now, he's going to be able to drop the weapon for Tabson and probably pick up an op for himself, or maybe swap one with Alu. But the rest of them should be able to have enough cash to actually buy.
Oh man, this is too close for comfort right now. How did it get to this stage? Mouse Sports, they had the first half. 10-5 was the scoreline in favor of Mouse Sports on the Terry side of Mirage. It's a very strong start, and now all of a sudden they seem to be really struggling defending against Titan, who have woken up after a really long and deep slumber. And actually, if we look at this Titan scoreboard, it's not just Kenny anymore. It's Scream and MBK, and everyone else is starting to wake up, so maybe Titan can really close out this game. Flashbang in, Legia peeks afterwards. Smiths is going to go down. That's Casey Y. And Legia picks off Scream, looking really good with the defense here, as Kenny does take down one kill, but is it enough? NBK fighting it out. Casey Y staying alive, and Samson takes down Kenny. Now it's looking great, and this could be the lead that Mouse Sports need. Now, Mouse Sports, they have the money, and actually Titan do have enough money to buy for this upcoming round as well.
It was a chaotic round. I was watching KZ the entire time, and I was deathly afraid for him because he was basically just running back and forth between, well, crossfires from Titan. He was lucky to stay alive that round, and especially with his acrobatics on the ladder there.
Oh, I like this.
I love this. Yeah, you like this too, Anders?
I do. I'm a fan.
Oh, man. It's good to know. It's good to know. I mean, this is legit. I like the fact that Mouseports push up through mid like this to get information and potentially just catch Titan off guard. But right now, it's going to be Mouseports just trying to hold this A site. Again, NBK is going to take point going through to CPL, and this is his position. Alu needs to find Smiths faster than that. That was a bit of a missed shot there from Alu, and that was a big opportunity. But he's going to make it up, get two frags, and brings it back to a 3-on-3.
Existence very nearly going down here. He's actually trapped in the middle of the bomb site in a weird way. Now he's still in there, and they haven't put the bomb down. Now he's finally going to be able to do it, and there's just time for it. But this is still a 2-on-3 that could very easily spin out of control. Alu alive, looking with the AWP. Kenny's in the back here. Alu, he's going to make the jump once. Flashes over. KZY now creeping on closer on Existence. I'm not sure why he's even showing himself right now. Great smoke coming up here. That's going to block them off, and Kenny goes down. This is not over yet. It's still a 2-on-2. That bomb has to be defused, and Existence is not looking the right way. Bomb goes down, and there it is. KZY picking up the kills, but he's enough time. Oh my god. What an absolutely clutch round coming out from Mouse Sports. So close, and it works out anyway. 14-12, and I actually fought with Alu. When he went down on the bomb there, I thought that was going to be it.
Well, they did cut it as close as they could. That was just a really good round from KZ once again. Surviving for a long time. I was a tiny bit surprised that he didn't go for the denial of the bomb, because it felt like it looked like he knew where Existence was for a large part of the time, and that he had control of where the bomb could potentially be planted. So I was kind of expecting him to deny the bomb plant, but they made it work, luckily for them.
They did. Tamsin aggressive in the middle here. Semler, you were a fan last time, and it actually works out for Tamsin in spite of some quite sloppy play, quite sloppy spray coming out, in fact, there. But I guess a kill is a kill, and the aggressive nature here of Mouseports is coming into play again.
Yeah, I like to see that as well. It's kind of Mouseports' signature, isn't it? You know, they love to play aggressive. They love to get in your face. CT side, peek around the map, get out there. It's like, especially like Mirage, it's like LGB almost. Not as aggressive as Mirage, or as LGB, but still, you know, they have a bit of it. So, Titan do manage to find one frag though on Tabson, so they bring him down and bring it back to a 4-on-4, but they're no closer to getting onto a site. They have managed to sneak a guy up into Connector, and I do like where Kenny S is playing right now. So they should be able to find something here towards this A site, but they still need to go and pick up the bomb, and that's going to cost them time.
Yeah, 30 seconds. They're really cutting it close. And KZY sneaking through the absolute most beautiful time. He spots Kenny. He's going to be walking right behind him, taking him down easily. And then in the middle, Existence. And a little bit of a lag on GoTV there as Existence finally goes down. Scream now in a 1-on-4 here. And great timing from KZY. Even is going to be surviving for much longer than he should. Alu coming in and actually misses that one shot. But Scream is on 19 points of health here. And he should be going down any second. Grenade to follow. 10 seconds left. Alu will finish him. And that's going to be 15-12. KZY has been finding some incredible timings on this second half here, I think.
He's basically just sneaking past certain death each and every time. So he's one of the first to successfully sneak through the death hole.
It's the murder hole, man.
In any case, Mouseports at match point, and the buy that Titan has to force up is really shoddy. We're talking two Seasons of 75s, PT-50, and two Galils. This is going to be so hard for Titan to actually pull off, especially with the way. Look at how Legia is playing, how aggressively he's up.
Yeah, he's going to get the kill as well, which again gives them some information. Now, they might be able to take the B bomb site here. Smokes go in. Chris will actually get that click on. Not a lot of time to react. He misses the next one, but this might still be just fine. It's a 5-on-3 retake here, and this one, Samlor, is for the map.
Yeah, this is it. It's all or nothing now, and they do have the 2-man advantage in the end. Kenny S and Scream are still alive, but we lose Kenny, and now it's Scream with the Galil. But he's 1v4, he's stuck behind the van, and there isn't too much hope for him here left on this map. Mousesports about to come up through with a huge win versus Titan, and that is just going to get them that much closer to that fourth spot, basically. Titan dropping a loss, two losses for them tonight in the Star Series, whereas now Mousesports, they should be in like the fifth or sixth position in this group stage.
Big surprise, Mousesports. I mean, I think we just need to take them more seriously in the future because they are really shaping up to be a much better team almost week by week. So really excited about that and happy to see that they're doing so well. We do need some German teams. I mean, I'm going to call them a German team anyway. We do need some more Germans in Counter-Strike playing at the top level. That's what I'm saying here. Now, guys, we do have a really quick break. It's going to be just a quick 5 minutes and we'll be right back here with Na'Vi and LDLC. So don't go anywhere. It's going to start very, very soon.